Are you a network engineer looking to become a cloud engineer? If so, this video is for you. Hi, my name is Michael Gibbs, and I'm the founder and CEO of GoCloud Careers. And we're an organization that's dedicated towards building the most high-performance cloud computing careers. Personally, I've been working in technology now for over 25 years. And I've been helping others get their first tech job or get promoted in tech for more than 2 decades. And I want to help you get cloud hired. In today's video, we're going to talk about taking network engineers and turning them into cloud engineers, which is something that I love, I'm very passionate about, and very familiar with. I've been in networking now for over 25 years. I've been a CCIE now for over 20 years. In fact, my CCIE number is 7417. Back when the CCIE was a monster two-day exam. And I've been training network engineers at Cisco Systems, Riverstone Networks, and I've been coaching them wherever I've been for more than 2 decades. Now I help people get cloud computing jobs, specifically cloud architect jobs and cloud engineer jobs. And I love, love, love working with network engineers. And here's why network engineers are so advantaged to becoming cloud engineers. The cloud is nothing more than a network in a data center. And when cloud services are there, they're just virtualized network and data center services. So the network engineers now already half of cloud computing before they actually start. Now there's still some training that needs to be done specifically on the data center technologies. Some network engineers will already have these skills and other network engineers will not. And let's talk about why that is. There are certain network engineers like me that only focused on networking, meaning we were pure routing and switching people or pure unified communications people. That's not actually even networking, that's more unified communications. But we focused on one thing. And I can tell you, I spent about 5 years on nothing other than BGP, and another 5 years on nothing other than IP multicast with PIM sparse mud and some of that old-fashioned DVMRP. So people like me that were purely focused on the network have to learn the data center. Now there are what I call hybrid network engineers, which also did network engineering, maybe they touched a little Linux, did a little DNS, did a little Active Directory. Those people have a lot more of the skills that are the cloud-related skills. So no matter where you're at as a network engineer, you're advantaged because you already know the network. So now it's just the data center. So what do you really need to know? If you're not a network engineer that's worked on BGP, and I don't mean configuring BGP, I mean designed it, determine your peering points, your peering locations, determine how to tune and optimize your performance. If you've done that, you've got it. You already have the BGP skills you need for the cloud. But if you don't have that because you are more configuring than engineering, guess what? Make sure you get a good concept in BGP. Now also, in the cloud, we are very limited to our routing. The routing capabilities are remind me of 1996 to 2000 networking capabilities. Possibly a little better, but not much more. Meaning when I started, you could only hold a very small number of routes in the routing table. And when you connect to the cloud, you're dealing with a very small number of routes. You can only send them 100 routes via BGP. And that means as a cloud network engineer, you must be great, great, great at IP addressing, subnetting, supernetting, and route aggregation because those skills are really critical. Now, most network engineers have the remaining networking skills. So let's talk about those other non-networking skills. The data center skills, the Linux skills, and the infrastructure as code. If you're a network engineer, you're going to need to learn the data center. Let's first start with the data center. This means servers and server virtualization, containers and container orchestration, storage area networks such as block storage, object storage, file storage, and file sharing protocols such as NFS or server message block. Now, as network engineers, especially pure network engineers, we don't typically work on load balancers. So network load balancers, application load balancers, as well as reverse proxies are things that are key to our career as cloud engineers. Now going on with that, databases. Cloud engineers may be working on databases, so relational databases as well as NoSQL databases. Cloud engineer needs to know databases. Now when we're dealing on the cloud engineering side, we still have to have some familiarity with the actual applications that we're dealing with. ERP systems, CRM systems, for example, unified communication systems, which many network engineers know a lot about. We're going to be dealing with identity and access management, both at the cloud providers and their configuration, a specialized configuration, but also things like Active Directory. A good cloud engineer knows how to set up an Active Directory server and manage it and federate it with whatever cloud they're working with. Next generation firewalls, VPN concentrators, IDS, IPS systems, critical knowledge for the cloud engineer. And the cloud engineer should also be familiar with things that get into the servers. So let's talk about the servers as the next component, Linux and Windows. You will need to have a good, strong understanding of managing Linux, installing applications, locking down Linux systems by removing packages, working with Linux-based firewalls, for example, like UFW or IP tables or whatever the new firewall is that's in vogue, installing other critical applications on these systems, managing these systems, and administering these systems. Now, we might actually work with Windows servers, not that many of them, but everybody's got an Active Directory server. Most people have an Exchange server, and lots of businesses have Windows servers for various reasons, specifically Windows-based applications. So knowing how to set up a Windows server and manage it is also critical skills for the cloud engineer. Now let's talk about coding. The pure network engineers, at least the old school ones like me, don't code. Newer network engineers are typically used to writing a Python script to automate things. So if you have that skill, guess what? You don't need to learn Python. You may also know how to write a bash shell script. Many network engineers do to automate certain things. So if you don't know how to write a bash script, you're going to have to learn to write a bash script. So that's kind of the compute kind of functionality that we're talking about, the servers and the scripting, Windows and Linux, Python, Bash, etc. In the old days, people like me would take in Notepad or VI in Unix, and we'd make a little config T script that we would cut and paste into our routers. And, you know, now that was good for one router, but now we're going to have to do things like infrastructure as code. We may need to deploy 1,000 virtual machines and virtual networks and all kinds of things in a matter of minutes. So the network cloud engineer, when they become a cloud engineer, must learn Terraform and infrastructure as code skills. Now at this point, you actually know the entire cloud. And what's next is very simply picking up a vendor's documentation and learning the translation for and how to set them up on their command line. How easy is it? Well, if you understand server virtualization, you understand the AWS Elastic Compute Cloud instance, which is their virtual machine, the Google Compute Engine instance, for example, which is their virtual machine, and the Azure virtual machine, or the Oracle virtual machine. Say, all clouds are really the same. They're just networks and data centers. So you've got to learn those networking and data center things. And then all you need to know is learn the cloud names that the cloud provider's marketing teams come up with for the same technology you possibly worked with for the last couple of decades. So remember, cloud computing is just a network and a data center, and those are the critical skills. So I told you the skills that you probably have as a network engineer versus the things that you need in the cloud. Then after you master those fundamental skills, and that means you know the cloud, then realistically speaking, when it comes to the AWS cloud, the Azure cloud, or the Google cloud, all you need to know is the names of those services and how to configure those services, and you're on your way as a cloud engineer. Because you have so much of that knowledge as a network engineer. In fact, I know so many network engineers that I've turned into cloud architects, for example, and the transition is much, much, much simpler because it's then learning the cloud-specific skills, and you've got so many of these skills from your network engineering background. If you're looking to get your first cloud architect or cloud engineer job and you don't know where to go, please join me on the completely free How to Get Your First Cloud Job webinar, which we do every Thursday. Please sign up. The link is in the description below. If you've got questions about your cloud computing career, guess what? You can join me online completely free on YouTube, Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays. Subscribe and hit the bell to be informed of the newest session, or just look at our website or our LinkedIn profile, and we'll post these things so you can get cloud hired by knowing exactly what to do 3 times per week on Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I look forward to seeing you in another video very soon. Take care.